Hi, you beautiful humans. My name is Ariane Andrew.
I'm Matt Dillon, and welcome to another piping hot episode of Sipping the Tea.
Where we sip the tea and our guests
spill that tea. You can grab that single coming out on iTunes, 99 cents next week.
Free 99 cents.
What's happened, Miss Mama?
We have little Glitty here.
And we have certified cover girl. Girl, she is in the house tonight. RuPaul, honey, it is Rose Bertram. What up, girl?
Hey, girl.
She is model extraordinaire, and girl, she's making me feel all kinds of way. I need to go and get a makeup artist on this set right now.
She's just serving looks, that natural beauty girl.
Welcome.
Thank you.
We're so happy to have you, Miss Thing.
Yeah, me too.
So is Miss Mama and Miss Glitty.
Okay, so let's just dive straight on into it. Okay, so take us back. You were born in Belgium.
Yes.
And you have been traveling all over the place. You haven't even been in LA for only 2 months. So take us back. How did you go from Belgium now to LA?
So, well, for the people that don't know me, I'm a model. And I have been modeling since I was 13. I've been traveling to the States since I was like 17. So I have been going to the States back and forth. But because my boyfriend is a soccer player, we like lived... And a very sexy one, too.
ding, ding, come the ears.
Yeah, so we have been moving to, like, so many places, Italy, Turkey, France, and now we're in L.A. He's retired. I can do my modeling, finally. I'm here with you guys, and I'm ready to sip some tea.
Oh, spill some tea.
Let's have a little sip, honey. I want to talk about one of the accolades that I was researching, because I was like, who is this pretty face? Mm-hmm. I want all the, you know, pull down the curtains and get to some stuff. One of the biggest things that I found was that you were one of the first models from Deutschland that were part of this.
From Belgium, honey.
Belgium, honey. Oh, sorry, girl.
Belgium,
from,
yeah.
That was part of the Sports Illustrated swimsuit edition.
Yeah.
Which is in itself so iconic.
Yeah.
So how did that kind of, you know, representing an entire country, how was that for you as the first?
So basically, I went to New York when I was around 18 years old.
Baby.
Yeah. And one of the biggest things that still shocks me to the day of today is that I'm very small in height. So when I went to New York and I went to visit like agencies, they always told me like, you're too small. We can't like sign you because we're looking for like super tall, skinny models. So I was kind of like sad because like my whole vision was to like model, and I was always doing it for years, but it wasn't like professionally, you know, it was just like once in a while. So then I had an agency that was really interested in me just because they like my personality, and they were like, you know, you're short, but we'll try it. Yeah. So yes, they sent me to...
Vibe. Yeah.
Got the vibe. I was about to say.
That's a good vibe.
You definitely have, I think, what's that called? The it factor.
Yeah, you do have an it factor.
Got the it factor.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, I guess.
They clearly thought you had the it factor too, though.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. So they believed in me. They signed me. I went to a few castings, which was Sports Illustrated. And I was so excited because, you know, Sports Illustrated is like super iconic. I'm a girl from Belgium, which, you know, we don't really like go to the States and think we can model. You know what I mean? We're like a super small country. But I've always been like kind of a crazy one and wanted to live my dreams and just go for it. So I just went for it. I went to the casting. I was myself. They asked me a bunch of questions. I just told the truth, how I am as a person. And then next thing you know, I got like a call back, had another conversation, and then I was there in the magazine.
Look at you, girl.
I did it for 3 years. Then I got pregnant.
Okay, now you're skipping way to the end. I was like, hold on.
Then I got confident. Then I got pregnant. And then, yeah.
That's insane, though. I mean, like, that's the universe telling you you're doing something right.
Yeah,
because,
for sure.
Like, Sports Illustrated, the swimsuit edition, is kind of like the threshold for a lot of people to be
it
like,
is.
I made it.
Yeah.
And baby 18 years old over here, she's like, girl, I'm just going, you know. But it's that enigmatic vibe that you give. There's an energy here
yeah.
that I'm like, I feel like that's part of the success. You have a fabulous look, don't get me wrong, but I think the vibe of...
Exactly. Because anyone can be... There's so many pretty girls, you know?
Yeah.
What
I know.
Bye, Felipe. There's so many pretty girls, but you have just such this good... Like, even just talking to you before we even did this interview, it's just like... Your energy is so magnetic. I feel like you just draw people to you.
Thank you.
You know,
you could be
stank. You know, you could walk in here and be like, oh, you know, I'm just.
Well, that's how a stank bitch where that door is. So let me tell you, girl. Keep it cute, girl.
So no. you got pregnant, and then let's talk about the cover of Dutch Vogue.
Yeah.
In your pregnancy, showing it off. So how did that?
She in Louis Vuitton, honey.
Louis Vuitton.
And, and
that's a funny story because you know it's Louis Vuitton, right? So what I wanted to do is I wanted to buy that same jacket that was on the cover for me to shoot it like right after I gave birth with like a flat stomach, just to have like the pregnancy cover and then like the flat stomach cover. But then I saw the price of the jacket and I was like, you know, maybe I'll just Photoshop it on top of the picture because that shit is too expensive.
You would think that's so iconic that I would be like, here, girl.
Right?
Oh my God. Yeah, no. I was about to say, I looked at the price of it. I was like, because she's making like, some queens.
Yeah,
how
like $15,000 for a jacket.
Oh,
which, you know, like, let's just sip on the tea.
I'll sip it and I'll cheese you because regardless of whether you got the jacket or not, you create an iconic moment.
For sure,
with your daughter, that
it was,
will be forever inked for what it stood for, but also for you personally. I think that's such a cool moment that you'll have forever. And I'm like, you're part of the Vogue family now.
Yeah, for sure. Because I always wanted to do a Vogue cover. And, you know, like I told you in the beginning, they always said I was like not tall enough to do any fashion. And like Vogue is like the top of fashion.
Correct.
You know what I mean? So having a cover and being, I think there's only like three people that have, or like three women that have like a pregnancy Vogue cover. And it's Giselle, I guess, and Miranda Kerr. I'm not sure. Hey, don't judge me if it's not them.
It's definitely Miranda.
It's definitely like.
You're in number one, you're in an illustrious company.
Sorry?
With those women, that's made your company to be in.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
To be one of those, I think is fabulous. And I just think, you know, it creates a movement for what is the norm and what is not the norm. You know what I mean? Bodies and what have you should be celebrated at, you know, in every stage. And I think a woman giving, you know, having a child is such a special thing.
For sure.
That for Vogue to do that is really iconic. And I think they should be doing more of that, less of what they're putting on their covers these days.
Yeah.
And
These social media influencers, these days on these covers, you know, let you know,
zip that girl. Let them have their shine. They're, you know.
Everybody needs a shine.
Everybody needs a little shine, a little shout out.
Everybody needs a shine.
True.
So, both of those major kudos on all of that. But I think you were talking about, we skipped and we said, don't say it yet. You're on the cover with pregnant. So let's talk about the baby, maybe.
Yeah.
Yes, let's talk about your little nugget.
Mommy.
Yeah, I'm a mommy, and life has changed a lot since I became a mom.
She got one bag on her eye.
And so tiny, I'm like, ooh, girl, you're snatched.
Yeah, I just eat yogurts.
You just eat yogurt?
Oh.
No, I'm very occupied with food, so... I have changed my lifestyle over like 3 years ago because I was always doing these like low carb diets and just thinking like not eating a lot will help with me changing my body because I've always been kind of tiny, but I've never been really in shape until I like changed my diet and then started working out like frequently. So it's all about like changing your diet. And that's why I started my own meal prep company, which is called Chubby in Shape.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Everyone needs some of that.
I like how you just lead it. You live
She's like, oh, I got a meal prep company.
Right in there. Yeah. So I started my own meal prep company, and just because I love food and I love to cook, and that's basically how I kind of got in shape.
Wait,
smart.
Yeah, I love that. So wait, are you going to? I know it's only in Europe right now. Are you have any plans for it to like come over here in the U.S.?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
So right now we are launching our recipe book. It's a Dutch recipe book, of course, but we're gonna do it in English as well. which is hopefully this year still, but we're gonna see how it all goes in Europe. It's going well, and I think everyone here in the States would want to have a copy. So
I agree. Yeah. I think you touched on when you were leading into the reason why is because I like the fact that you're honest and said that you would, you know, you've always been a slimmer build, mm-hmm. but you've never been like in shape health wise. Yeah. So it's like not only the food component, but the exercise and the mental and all of that. I like the honesty in that because a lot of people would be like, well, you know, I just am this because I am this. You know what I mean? But to truly be in health and shape mm-hmm. and fitness is the food, is the portions,
sure.
is actually understanding what goes in is what, you know, what you end up looking like ultimately. And I love that you were just so frank about that.
Yeah, because it's basically what your body is able to digest well. So it's just changing little things in your diet, like eating whole wheat and stuff of like...
Whole wheat? I was like, whole wheat, girl? I'll see you outside after for that one. Whole what?
Whole wheat.
Girl, you be there too.
Whole wheat.
No, that is
whole
not
wheat.
My friend.
Sorry. I'm not born with English, but that's
what I said.
No, so whole wheat.
I got you, girl.
You got it, girl.
Yeah.
He just messed up.
Whole wheat, try to not eat or drink too much milk. You know, just certain things in your meals that you just change. And over time, it's not going to change after 1 week.
Yeah.
Totally.
But over time, you know, when you change your diet, you'll start seeing results within your body. So that's what I did. And I don't have a six pack yet, but...
But girl, you are looking fabulous.
She's like living, breathing the authenticity behind saying I have a meal plan company and a book and all of this. I think that a lot of people come out with, you know, books and concepts
mm-hmm. that don't really
just
work.
Just to sell.
Yeah. Just because they have like, numbers and followers and the
platform. Definitely like our recipe book is really the meals are like it's not like a low carb diet at all. It's like. It's pancakes, it's burritos, it's tacos, it's pasta.
I'm hungry.
But the ingredients are the ones that make your body, you know what I mean? So if you have healthy ingredients, then you can just eat whatever you want, but just kind of base it out.
And it has a pretty face on it too. So it's going to sell some copies, girls. Sell the copies.
Wait, so speaking of balance, because you're saying like, you know, balance, how do you balance being a mom, you know, having a boo thing and your meal prep company and still being able to, you know, stay true to yourself, especially now living in LA with all the chaos. Like, how do you balance all that, girl? Because it's
welcome.
A lot.
Yeah.
Welcome.
Yeah. Yeah.
She's fresh.
It's an interesting question because coming to LA, it does change a lot, you know, because I was in Europe all the time. And then when you have an event, you're not going to fly from Europe to LA to go to an event.
Yeah.
Now I'm here and now it's there's pressure. I've only been here for 2 months and it's interesting because I came to your short film.
Yeah, girl.
And when I saw your short film, I could totally relate because, you know, like sometimes I'm at home and I'm like on Instagram and scrolling and I see these girls on a carpet and I'm like, damn, why am I not on a carpet right now? And then you have a beautiful baby at home with an amazing husband.
Boom.
And I was just thinking all the time, like, why am I not on this carpet? I need to post this picture. I need to show that I'm doing this as well. And it gets to your brain so much that when I saw your short film, I was like, wow.
Isn't that crazy? It is
the way it is, you know? Like, you always want to show, like, the best things in life and like, the best parts of your life.
But meanwhile, you're live in
sometimes
it, you're living it.
I'm also living it. Like,
you're living your best part.
Yeah, I'm living the best part, but sometimes I'm in this part where I'm like, damn, I want to be on that carpet.
So good. Or girl, but you're your own, like, you're people look at you and probably think the same exact thing.
Yeah.
But look, you were just saying, like, you just got a house, mm-hmm. you know, like all these amazing things. So, I mean, you are your own superpower. And girl, like, I can't wait to see what's gonna like happen for you because your energy's so bomb. And
get that first cover of Vogue in America, chat. Come on,
man. Yeah, I hope so.
I see big things.
You never know.
Unless you put it out there in the universe, you know?
I think for sure.
I think your energy and the vibe that you give, there's nothing you can't do.
Thank you.
And I love that you have a beautiful man and a beautiful baby and it's all, and she's so put together. I'm just like, girl.
And she's a comedian on the side.
I was about to say, honey, we saved that for the outtakes, honey.
Yes.
Listen, we're not filming now, so get dirty, girl. Get dirty.
We're still filming, girl.
Yeah, when I'm not on camera, I'm more dirty.
Oh, well, that was tense. No. Yeah.
I got beat in part two, guys.
I was like, that's $5.99.
Okay, so like for everyone who's like living under a rock, unless you have some more
questions. I'm good, Juicy. Okay. I'm good.
Well, for everybody who's living under a rock, girl, and don't know who you are, and you want people to follow you, girl, plug yourself right there
in that camera there, right, girl. Here.
Where?
Right there. Oh. She's like, where? Bam! Where? She's like, where am I? That's fabulous. That's the best. That's the best intro I've ever seen.
That is.
Go away, girl.
Yeah.
So, hi, I'm Rose Bergeron. Now I'm gonna do it again. So, hi guys, thank you for watching the video. If you don't know who I am and you're living under a rock, then just follow at Rose Bertram. Well, Rose_Bertram. Go check out my meal prep company called Chubby in Shape. We have a recipe book launching soon in English. So if you're interested in getting a six pack, just go do that and purchase it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Bye bye.
She is so cute. I love you.
I did my best. Yeah. I saw eyes. I was like,
No, girl, you're good. We're gonna have to go pussy pop one of these men.
I like this girl. All right, well.
On that note, guys. Thank you for watching Sipping the Tea. You can follow me across the board at Ariane Andrew and this little nugget at Glitty Glitter.
You can follow me at MattDillon 1983 and It's Mama 2011. Until next time.
Until next time, guys, on EverTalk TV. We'll catch you next Tuesday.
Let's cheers it out, girl.
Cheers.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah, you got the wrong number. Click.